there is a corner of the world where the sea shuts each season, melodiously in and out of the crest-filled streams, where the gobsmacked trout line up to be looked at, and where the steamboats still come and go at regular intervals. There is a corner of the world where the trees that had been climbed by Celts and children and owls still line the route to the sea, and where the long evenings haul the sound of the sea out of seashells and down the path to the small village. There is a corner of the world where when the sun sets, the romance of singing sits on the back of the clouds, hung up over the mountains to fall calmly and warmly into the doorway, where the dryness of the day is preluded by dew-dropped, frost-cracked white. There is a corner of the world where a hand attached to a huge rock holds a small white flower, where the dew from the early morning drips a tear down the flower's stem and off the small finger of the hand down onto the ground. It makes a quiet sound. There is a corner of the world where the porpoise, poised like a prince, spews the poison from its gut and lingers in this death trap, where the herring gull ripped on the rocks rests, where there's a fish with no gills. There is a corner of the world where a bullet has just passed through a wall into a baby's stomach, where the evening brings fear and where the truth about what happened will never be known. There is a corner of the world where a bolt placed purposefully holds a piece tenderly in place, where a sudden sharp scream, scalpel-like, freezes the evening as a child is born. There is a corner of the world where a starfish hangs under the moon on a ladder with twigs still growing from its rungs, where the streets have carpets covered in crisp autumn leaves, and it speaks to us in whispers and shouts out its lies and speaks the truth. There is a corner of the world where we must listen and decide and learn and understand and repair.